So, all right. I know I'm not going to get any predictions out of you.
Are we still in predictions?
I've asked three times.
I'll give you a prediction.
Yeah.
Yeah, what?
You said you'll give me a prediction.
Okay, a prediction. There's going to be more and more incursion by the federal government and other governments based in Europe and elsewhere on the internet. We're going to start seeing a situation start to apply where the FCC starts to move in. They tried to at one time move in on cable TV, but there was too much pressure against that. But now they see the internet wide open using the shoehorn issue, of course, is net neutrality. They're going to find a way to become all of a sudden the gatekeeper of the internet. And the next thing you know, they're going to be licensing for blogs and all the rest of it. It's going to be a complete disaster, and it's coming your way.
So
except that I told you that on this show about 2 years ago when you were a big enthusiast for net neutrality in those days.
Well, I still am.
You said if we didn't get net neutrality, we were going to end up at 200 baud or something.
Well, I still am.
I told you.
No,
we don't have net neutrality.
We don't have net neutrality.
The FCC's attempt to pass it is so compromised.
No, but the FCC is going to use that issue as that was the problem. The problem with these things is that net neutrality may be a great thing to do, but if you create a bureaucracy to do something, it won't do what you told it to. It will do what it wants to do.
No, I agree with you. And that's obviously a problem we're facing. I mean, look, we're squeezed from two directions.
It's been told by Congress not to touch the Internet. It's been told by the courts not to touch the Internet. So what did they do? They immediately came out with regulations saying that they're in charge of the Internet after all.
Jerry. So they're getting it from the left and the right. I mean, there are plenty of bloggers that are complaining that the FCC sold out, that it didn't do enough, that it basically was a cop-out, that we've got other people on the right who are complaining that it's taking over the Internet, that it's going to be socialism. I think the fact of the matter is it did practically nothing. And whether or not this net neutrality turns out to have any impact at all, we'll have to see. But I doubt if it's going to accomplish anything.
It asserted its right to do something which it was explicitly told it did not have the authority to do. Once it gets away with the right, you will be surprised what it does. That isn't my prediction.
Why? Why, Jerry? Why would they want to do that? What would be the interest of the FCC in doing that?
Well, let me take over for a second, Jerry. You can tag
the
team.
Beginning?
Ah. Jerry, hold on.
Do you want me to go on a little further of some of the things that the net does that irritates the government? Can't you think of a lot of things that the net does that the government wishes didn't happen?
Well, I can think of one.
Well, it's not only that. Let me interrupt here. It's not about having worked for the government at one point. The government agencies, especially something like the FCC, which is losing a lot of authority because broadcasting and all these other things are less and less important, wants to do something with its people. They want to expand like all other government agencies, and this is an excuse to do it for no other reason. It just turns out that most of this will be bad for everybody.
Yeah, you got it. I mean, it's Purnell's iron law of bureaucracy. Bureaucracies are, my iron law. Bureaucracies have two kinds of people. They're the kind of people who are dedicated to what the bureaucracy was created to do, like classroom teachers, most of them. And there are people who are dedicated to making sure the bureaucracy itself has power and stability and continuity. The second kind always get in control. Always. There never was a bureaucracy where the second kind...
It's not as if the FCC invented net neutrality. There's been pressure from a lot of corners, including a number of internet companies that are worried about the cable companies and the phone companies throttling them. So it's not just
about net neutrality, that's the point.
That are coming up with network neutrality. It was also part of Obama's campaign promise.
Well, every pornography producer in the world wants net neutrality.
Okay.
Everybody would love to have the rest of us subsidize the kid down the street who spends 24 hours a day downloading porn.
Or whatever.
There's no, it's not about net neutrality. It's about government encroachment, and that's what the real key is here. And the other reason that you leave out in your law, Jerry, is the fact that the only way that you can make more money in the government is if your agency gets bigger and you have more people to supervise.
Well, yeah, but that's Parkinson's law. I didn't invent that. That's been around since C. Northcote Parkinson wrote Parkinson's laws 30 years ago. And it's all true. Governments expand without regard to their jobs. They just expand.
The biggest push from Washington is going to be on privacy. Facebook is going to do something to really piss off Congress, and I don't know what they're going to do. The Federal Trade Commission is already making noises, although admittedly tepid noises, and I think we're going to see some type of privacy legislation in 2011, and I think the industry is going to be really split over whether to support it or not.
Well, I love
another
it.
Another excuse to butt in.
For three guys who weren't willing to give me any predictions, those are some pretty damn good predictions. Thank you. Well, yeah,